Hey everyone, Matt here with the Maya Learning Channel. Today I want to go over how to export and import compounds in Bifrost. This is useful if you build a custom tool that you want to save for the future or share with others, or conversely if you find a useful compound someone else made that you want to use too. So here I've made a simple bulge deformer that works from the center of an input locator. Now I'd like to package it up and send it off. So first I'll select the relevant nodes and hit Ctrl G to make a compound, which I'll call Bulge Deformer. Now, there's two ways I can save this. If I were to go to Create Publish Graph, then it would save the entire graph to my Bifrost browser. This is useful for very complex graphs with lots of compounds, but in this case, I really only want to publish my single compound. So instead, I'm going to select the compound and go to Create Publish Compound. This allows me to save just this compound node to wherever I choose. By default on Windows, it goes to my user folder. I'm okay with the location, but I'm going to change the namespace since I plan to upload this to the Autodesk Area Forum. That'll make it a bit more organized. Now, this is actually already a usable tool. I could send this off to other people as is, but I think it would be nice to add a little documentation that would appear in the Info tab here, like a lot of other nodes in Bifrost. To do that, I need to create what's called an MD or Markdown file. The easiest way to do this is to go to Bifrost's existing compounds, which you can find in your install directory, and duplicate one of the files you see there. Then I'll drop it in my user folder and rename it bulgedeformer.md. Now if I open this file with a text editor, you'll find some examples of how to do your documentation, which I can compare against the actual node I copied this from. As you can see, the general convention is the more hashtags that are in front of text, the higher the header level. So on the first header level, I'll put the name of the compound, then a short description. I can leave this inputs header since it's just a general identifier of the input values feeding my compound. But after that, I'll need to change each of these triple hashtags to my actual input descriptions. There, that looks good. Now I just need to make sure my compound points to this MD file. So next I'll open the deformer's JSON file. Down here, under the first meta tag, I'm going to add the following. Note that this line in particular is a relative path from the JSON file to the MD file. So if you put your documentation into a subfolder or elsewhere on your hard drive, you'll need to change this accordingly. And once that's done, I'll restart Maya. Now if I start up a new graph, you'll see my bulge deformer appears in the Autodesk Area section, complete with documentation. I can easily zip these two files up and send them off. And as you probably already guessed, importing other people's compounds is as easy as copying them into this directory, whether they have associated markdown documentation or not. Now I can easily combine my compounds with others to iterate and form new compounds.